Hi everybody, Joel with Rock Island Auction Company, here to show you some of the exceptional firearms in our 2017 September Premier Firearms Auction. Now if you've been watching some of our sneak peek preview videos the last couple weeks, some of the guns on this table are gonna look pretty familiar. Now we all know Colt snake guns are really, really hot items right now. But personally, for my money, there's no better than a Smith & Wesson revolver, so I'm very excited to look at the Smith & Wessons on this table with you today. A lot of registered magnums, but I'd like to first take a look at the two on the table that are not registered magnums, and we're just gonna jump right in with one of the big boys. This is a Smith & Wesson 44 Special, but it is one of two known. Documented as factory engraved, first model, triple lock. This is an exceptionally rare, it goes without saying, it's an exceptionally rare Smith & Wesson revolver that even the most advanced collections are not gonna have a representative copy. It's an incredible piece that's gonna be an instant cornerstone of any collection. Moving on to the other revolver that is not a registered Magnum, but it is still a 357 Magnum, is this beauty. Just a sea of inky black finish, a vivid case-hardened hammer and trigger, and of course this bright golden, nearly pristine factory box is an impressive presentation. But perhaps most impressive of all is its former owner, Major General Julian Hatcher. Most of us know the name, of course, from Hatcher's notebook, but he was truly a firearms pioneer regarding research and even a few firearms designs. An exceptional revolver with perhaps even a more exceptional provenance in my mind. Let's move on to some of the Smith & Wesson registered magnums. First of all, to have so many on one table is truly a treat. Smith & Wesson registered magnums, there are only 5,224 ever made by Smith & Wesson. They are the first production 357 revolver that was ever made. They are essentially custom built handguns that have stood the test of time. It's been nearly 80 years and they still perform as some of the finest custom made revolvers today because they were custom made. They were made to order, each one registered to its owner by Douglas Wesson himself, hence the registered Magnum. Let's start over on the left because the engraving and work on this might look a little familiar to those who paid attention in our May auction. This is a Smith & Wesson registered Magnum, just dripping with gold and full coverage engraving. All the way down to the muzzle, we have these delicate gold inlays around the Smith & Wesson. Here we have a bison, we have a cougar on the crane, a standing bear, this beautiful scrimshaw-like vine and scroll. And on the other side, those grips have a standing cougar, a leaping stag, a ram, a wolf, a fox. It's an incredible gun. If you liked the gun in our May sale, but didn't like the celebrity price tag, this gun is a perfect opportunity to put that level of craftsmanship in your collection. Moving on next is a real rarity. It is one of 15 Smith & Wesson registered magnums that were bought by the US government for the US Postal Service. It's marked on the side, PO Department number 10. Has a fancier wood grain grip than most registered magnums. It is beautiful, it is pristine. There is not a drag mark on it. It is black. We're not able to confirm how many of the 15 are in existence. But with only 15, there are gonna be a lot of collectors that would be happy to have one of those in their safe. Moving right along, another registered Magnum. Obviously you can see we have 8-inch plus barrel. That's gonna be a rarity that collectors like. And again, at 80 years old, we're gonna come in close and really get a look at the condition of this. It is flat ink black, beautiful gun. Anybody would be lucky to have this revolver in their collection, especially for the rare peep sight on the rear. You don't see too many of those. If nothing else, that should stand out to anybody who's even not a serious Smith & Wesson collector, that this gun is a little something special. Moving on to the right, we have what we're calling the finest known Smith & Wesson registered Magnum. And that's a claim, but this gun stands up to it. We're gonna take a look at the full coverage engraving. Again, all the way down to the muzzle. This vine and scroll work is just exceptional. We have these grips with the inlaid buffalo, the inlaid bison on each side. But perhaps most impressive is the panel scenes. They're just above those grips. Here we have a cougar taking down a stag. The two does are hightailing it off into the distance. And the most impressive part is there's a distance. This is relief carved into the gun, and they're heading off over the hills and into these pine trees. There's mountains in the background. It's just the depths of the scene that you don't see other than some of the most, by the most accomplished master engravers. Flip around to the other side. We have another panel scene where all's fair play, where this one we could assume the same cougar is defending her two cubs from a huge eagle that's swooping down. And again, the mountains and pine trees in the back really set this panel scene apart and let you know you're handling something special. It's exceptional. It's the best, or it's the finest known registered magnum that we have. There's one registered magnum on the table that's here, not only because it's a registered magnum, but because of its cool factor. This registered magnum and this holster were once the property of none other than Hollywood star Gary Cooper, star of Sergeant York, star of High Noon, recognized by any number of Hollywood groups as just a master of his craft. And this is an ironclad provenance that goes back to 1962 when his estate sold it to Kerr's Sporting Goods in Beverly Hills, California. You can see this also has a fancier grain grip. It has been kept exceptionally well since that time. It is also just inky black. The holster to go with it, when you put one in the other, you can tell they've been together for decades. We're extremely proud to offer these. If you're a fan of Smith & Wesson revolvers and you're a fan of old Westerns, it doesn't get any better than this lot right here. These are less than a dozen of the Smith & Wesson revolvers in this auction that should have Smith & Wesson collectors tripping over themselves to add to their collection. You can go to www.rockislandauction.com, check out these and the hundreds of others in the September Premier Firearms Auction. That's September 8th, 9th, and 10th. And just as important as the preview day on September 7th, it's a full day. You can come to our facility, you can inspect and hold any of these guns that are gonna be in the auction, put them in your hand, feel the history, and we'll even have a little barbecue. We hope to see you there.